Hi everyone, welcome back to Homemade Chef. My name is Veena Azmanov and today I'm making tuna potato patties. You can find the recipe card for this on my blog or on my Facebook page. You have a pictorial for it on my Facebook, on my blog as well. Now, what I have here is a can of tuna that's being drained. I want to drain off all the liquid. Okay, so while that liquid is getting drained off, I have a chopped onion and a chopped garlic. I have a potato that I'm going to grate later, salt and pepper, but I also need egg and flour, which I'm going to get in a minute. But first I'm going to cook the onions. The reason you want to cook the onion is because you do not like it, the taste of raw onions in my tuna patties. I like the onions to be cooked, otherwise it takes more like a salad kind of taste, you know, a raw onion, and it doesn't taste nice, not for me. But if you like it, then you might go ahead and put it, but I prefer to cook the onions tad bit. It takes only 2 minutes. You just want the onions to release all the liquid and get translucent, and that's it. It's done. Okay, it really is not much time. Okay, now what I'm going to do is take a bowl, remove all the tuna from the can and put it in the bowl, and I'm going to shred the tuna because I do not want any lumps. I want a nice even this thing of tuna in my patties. Now you notice I have the egg and the flour already in my ingredients. Okay, I'm gonna shred it, add in the onion and garlic goes next, followed by the cilantro, then the eggs and the flour. Okay, now this is a great recipe to make when you are trying to get your kids to eat something for the first time, like tuna. So if you start, I used to make potato patties, and at first I started adding 1 tablespoon of tuna inside until the kids got used to that, then add a little more and then a little more, and now of course it's the whole tuna can goes in, and the kids love it because in the beginning they used to find tuna quite fishy, but now they do like it. In goes in salt and pepper. And notice I have not done anything with the potatoes so far, and that's because I do not want the potatoes to go brown. So now I'm going to immediately peel and grate it. Drain all the excess liquid because you do not want too much of liquid coming out of the potatoes. So you just want to drain off all that because the liquid in the potatoes can make your tuna patties soggy, and you do not want that. You want them to be moist but not soggy. On another side, I'm going to have a frying pan, a skillet, on medium heat while I prepare my patties. Okay, I'm going to put the potato in and just incorporate until it's all incorporated. You do not want to stir too much. You do not want to waste too much of time at this point of time because you do not want the potatoes to start browning. So just incorporate it, and that's it. Okay, now it's time to make the patties. You see my fry pan is on the gas. Now I'm going to use a quarter cup measuring cup to make my patties, and the reason I do this is because it gives nice even sized patties. Unfortunately the video is a little too close for comfort, so what I'm doing here is like the same thing I showed you on my tuna croquettes on my blog. I just use a quarter cup measuring spoon like I show you here. See here how evenly, well, these first and foremost look even, and they look nicer when you have to serve them for guests. Now I have my heat on medium high, and a little bit of oil, but you see this little bit will go a long way. I don't need any more than this. Okay, and I'm gonna cook these patties for 1 minute on medium high and then reduce the flame and cook them for 2 minutes on each side on low. And the reason I do that is because the first 1 minute kind of gives it that nice even browning, and then the 2 other minutes on each side will cook the potatoes right through, because remember we grated raw potato inside this. So while the tuna doesn't need to be cooked much, the potatoes do. Okay, now this recipe gives me about anything between 6 to 8 depending on the size of the potatoes. You do not want to add too much larger potato because then the egg will become less and you won't be able to, it won't bind. So you want to keep the proportion of the recipe that I have given you in this. Okay, now I'm gonna turn it and cook it for another 1 minute on high on the other side, and then 2 minutes on both sides on low, medium low. Okay, this is a very quick and easy way to cook dinner because it doesn't really take long. And you see that it's nice and evenly browned and it's all the way cooked. Okay, and you see I didn't use any more oil because there's no need to use any more oil. And the potatoes don't look oily because it doesn't taste nice when they're too oily. Not for me at least. So that's it. My tuna potato patties are done. And I do hope you try this recipe. If you do, share it with me on my Facebook page or my blog. And do subscribe and stay updated for some more recipes coming up. And that's all for me for now. I do hope you try these recipes and let me know. You can find me on my Facebook page, A Homemade Chef, or on my blog, ahomemadechef.blogspot.com. Bye-bye for now. This is Veena Azmanov from A Homemade Chef.